Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this wedding menu in Canva for free. So we're just in the home page of Canva, and I'm going to go along and click Create Design. And you can select from any of these options here, or you can go down to Custom Size. Now I'm going to create an A4 flyer. This is the same dimensions as A4. But if you want to make it A5, you can go to Custom Size here, and then you can place in the dimensions on the screen now. So let's just go back and select flyer, and then a new page will open. So the first thing we'll do is to put our graphics in. So if we go over to Elements here, and we go down to Graphics and click See All. Then if we go to the top here in the search bar, now, if you want to, you don't have to put these particular graphics in, but I've been looking for eucalyptus and foliage. If we put in eucalyptus, you can see there's a wide range of different options here. Now, the slight downside is that these here, which cover the top and all the bottom of your page, are actually the pro version. You can see they're all here, and including this one here. So there's two options. The first option is you can use individual branches like this, click and just drag them into your design. Then you can resize them, you can rotate them, you can put them in the corners, you can select it, hold down your Alt key on your keyboard, click and drag, and then you can actually make subsequent ones, and you can continue to do that to make up your design. You can also use additional branches if you want to, say this one here. And again, you can add that to this design. Let's just rotate this round. And then if you don't like it at the front or back, select it, select the three dots, and then you can click Arrange. You can send it backwards, one foliage leaf, or you can send it right to the back. So let's go to Send to Back, and you can see it's gone to the back. So you can do that, and you can do that with as many of these different options as possible. Now that's quite time consuming, so I'm going to show you another way to do this. Select them all, press delete. Let's go over to a website called Pixabay. So this is a website which provides free images. You do have to check the licensing on all of them, but you can use most of these images for free. So I'm just going to go to the search bar here and type in leaves foliage and press enter. You can see we've got lots of images here, but they're not really very suitable. So if you go to the top here, click on the drop down and select illustrations. And then you can see here we've got a number of different options that you can select from. Just simply scroll down, and if you see something you like, just click on it and download it. So if I go to page 2 and scroll down, I'm going to select this image here. Then I'm just going to click free download. I'm going to download it at the highest resolution and click download. Now I'm going to go back to our design in Canva. I'm going to go to uploads, then I'll select upload files. I'm going to go to my downloads and my image is here and just click upload. And as you can see, my image has now been downloaded. So this is all for free. I'm just going to click and drag this into my design. Now, because I want to crop this, I'm going to need two of them to have some foliage at the top and the bottom of my page. So select the image, hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag. And then this image here, I want to crop. So go up to Crop, and then simply pull down the purple bar, and then crop it to where you want it. You can crop the gold bar out if you want to, but I'm going to keep that. Press Enter. Move that to the top, click and drag out that foliage and pop it in the top here. And then with this one, go to crop and again do the same to the bottom. Press enter. And then, oh, I've done that the wrong way around. Let's just go back, Command or Control Z, go to crop. I want to actually bring that up. There we go, and press enter. And then once again, click and drag out this foliage. Again, you can just move it down if you don't want that gold bar in. In fact, let's do that. Just move that out. Perfect. If you want to make the design a bit smaller, you can do that. And then again, you can copy and paste this bit here and just move that along if you want to. You can make it bigger or smaller. Just move it across to the top, or you can move it around. It's completely up to you. So I'm just going to make it the same as the bottom. So I'm going to make that quite big. And in fact, I like the bottom design better. So I'm going to get rid of that. I'm going to copy and paste this, hold down my Alt or Option key, and then I'm going to actually turn that round and then pop that at the top. Now on this design, if we just click and drag out another one, on this design, when we go back up to crop, you can see our design hasn't disappeared. So we can actually use the whole of that design again. You will notice we've got some sides of this design as well. So if you didn't like the top or the bottom, you can actually use the side. So let's just have a look at that. And again, let's rotate this round. So you can actually use this design if you wanted to. Let's see if we can put that one at the top, see if that one's better. We'll just move that out, make that bigger. Move that to the top. No, I think I still prefer this one. So let's just get rid of that one and move this one to the top. Perfect. So now we're going to insert some text. So go to text. And then if you scroll down, we've got lots of different combination text. You do have to scroll down a little bit further. And you can see there's lots of combination text here that you can just simply click and drag into your design. Once you've done that, you ungroup it. You see these little white bars here, just click on those, completely ungroup it. And then you can move these sections around and you can actually put in your own design. So you can use any of these combinations, but I'm just going to enter in my own text. So if I just go to the top here, I'm going to add a heading, click inside. I'm going to press Command or Control A to select all of that text. And then I'm just going to type wedding menu. And then for this particular text, just select it all again, Control or Command A, go to the font. And for this particular font, let's go to the top here and I chose playlist script. There it is. So just click on that. And the font size for this one, I chose to be 60.5. Just press enter. And then we can just move that to the top there. Now I'm not going to worry too much about it being centered, but as you can see, once I move it over, you can see these pink bars that will appear and that tells me that it's now centered. But it's a really easy way to do that, but I'll do that at the end because it's easier. So for the next one, you can go back to text and then you can add a subheading. We enter this subheading, double click inside this subheading, and then I'm just going to type starter. And then for this one, my font was railway. There it is there. And then for this particular font, the size was 19. Press enter. Now, because I want three of these, starter, main, and dessert, I'm simply going to select it, hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag, and then do exactly the same for the dessert. Now, instead of inserting another text box again, I'm just going to click and drag out another one. But this time I'm going to change the font to, I'm going to go to the search bar here, change the font to Canva Sans. There we go. And then I'm going to change the font size to 15. Press enter. And now I'm just going to insert all of the text for my menu. Now you can use these bars at the side here to pull in this text box if you want the text to go on to the next line. Once you finish that one again, because you've formatted all this text, just hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag. Do that twice because we'll need one for the dessert. Okay, so once all of your text is in, you need to decide how far down you want this dessert line. So you could have it all the way down here or to here. Once you've made that decision, let's decide where you want the starter, probably about here. Then select all of the menu items in here, go to position, go to center, and then we're going to space evenly vertically. and then deselect. And if we just go down here to the very bottom, let me just move my screen. We go down here to the very bottom, you can zoom out and you can just see if there's anything that's a little bit annoying to the eye. So I'm happy with that. Once you're happy with it, just go up to the share button here and then you can simply download it, or you can share on social media, or you can print your design. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.